caught in the crossfire. What's up, guys? Lance, the Obscure Movie Guy, coming to you once again, bringing you another fun-filled, fact-filled video on movies that you don't care about. But that's what I specialize in. So, The Lost City came out, starring Sandra Bullock, Channing Tatum, and Daniel Radcliffe, and I thought, what better way to explore some of the lesser-known movies that those three have done? So we're going to go over three movies, one from Channing Tatum, one from Sandra Bullock, and one from Daniel Radcliffe that I thought was extremely entertaining. And, for the whole Lost City. And we did go see Lost City with the wife and the family. So it was actually not a horrible film. There have been better movies out there, but not completely terrible. It was entertaining enough. The kids actually semi-enjoyed it, and it had its moments. So, not bad. And that was the last Sandra Bullock filmed movie that she's going to be in a while. She does have other stuff that's in post-production that will be coming out later this year and into next year. But this was the last official filming that she has done. She's taking a sabbatical to concentrate on raising her child. So, her and Ryan Reynolds now are both on sabbatical. So, and I also hear Will Smith's on a voluntold sabbatical, along with Ezra Miller. Lots of stuff going on in Hollywood. Anyways, gonna go over three movies, probably none of which you guys have actually seen, but are all worth checking out. So the first one I want to start off with is Channing Tatum. All the women seem to love Channing Tatum. He annoys me, mostly because all the women love him. He's actually not a terrible actor. It's a little irritating. Lost City, he did a pretty good job. He's got really good comedic aspects in his acting ability. So he did a really good job in Lost City. But today we're going to look at something that's a little bit more dramatic, which he's also very good at doing. This film came out in 2011. It was called The Son of No One. The Son of No One is a 2011 American crime thriller written by Dito Montiel, based on the book of the same name that he had written. The film is actually the third collaboration between Montiel and Channing Tatum. Stars Tatum, Al Pacino, Ray Liotta, and Tracy Morgan. In 2002, a young cop named Jonathan White, who is played by Tatum, is a rookie officer under Captain Marion Mathers in Queens. Mathers is played by Ray Liotta. White grew up in Queens, and to provide for his wife, Carrie, and his ailing young daughter, he works hard to keep his life on track, but that life is threatened when dark secrets from his past get brought to light. An anonymous source reveals new information about two unsolved murders from 1986 in the same neighborhood. Flashback to 1986, and you'll find a 14-year-old Jonathan who killed two men in self-defense, and his friends Vinny and Vicky helped him dispose of the bodies and keep their involvement a secret from the authorities. The detective on the case, Detective Stanford, who is played by Al Pacino, knew Jonathan was involved in the murders, but disposed of the evidence out of loyalty to Jonathan's father, who had been his partner. So as I said, this was Tatum's third collaboration with Dito Montiel. Back in 2006, they did A Guide to Recognizing Your Saints with Robert Downey Jr. And in 2009, they had done the movie Fighting. 2011, they've done The Son of No One. And this movie is, it's not great. So there's a lot of pros and some cons to this movie. The pros is, it's got a great cast. It really does. Channing Tatum does an exceptional job. Ray Liotta is Ray Liotta. He's amazing in everything he does. Al Pacino, screen legend. And Tracy Morgan does a really, really surprising job in this film. In a very dramatic and traumatic role in the film. I was really surprised by Morgan's take. I think when somebody actually lets him not be Tracy Morgan, he can actually do a pretty good job. So the movie, the pros is everybody did a really good job on this movie. Some of the scenes are actually really well acted out. The performances are all really well done by everybody involved. The cons is, it's kind of a sloppy plot line. The basic plot actually doesn't sound that bad, but there is a couple things in the movies that didn't necessarily need to be there. The telling of it, the flashbacks are kind of in and out in kind of a weird way. So the movie lacked a good direction from the director himself, unfortunately. There is a couple parts where it's... The movie, I think, wants to be grittier than it actually is, and it just didn't come off that way. And there's also, like, I think it's trying for, like, an aha moment in the film, and it just doesn't quite grab you like you think it would. But overall, it's not a bad flick. I'd give it, like, a 5 out of 10. It's worth watching at least one time, especially if you're a Tatum fan. But overall, not completely horrible, but it's probably not something I would go back and watch again unless I really wanted to see it for some reason. It's not one of those things you're going to be flicking through the channels and be like, oh, this is on, and you're going to watch it. It's not one of those types of movies. It's not a Rocky IV. But not bad overall. Not great, not bad. It's not half bad, but it's not half good either. So there's that one. The next one I want to talk about is the Sandra Bullock film. Came out in 2015. Now, Sandra Bullock's, it was kind of hard to find a film that's kind of obscure and under the radar with Sandra Bullock because she does so many headlining movies. So I had to do some deep diving and I had to sit back and try and watch this. And it was a semi-interesting movie, based on actual events, based on a true story. It's called Our Brand is Crisis. Our Brand is Crisis is a 2015 American drama film directed by David Gordon Green and written by Peter Straugen, based on a 2005 documentary film of the same name. The film gives the fictionalized account of the involvement of American political campaign strategists in the 2002 Bolivian presidential election. The film stars Sandra Bullock, Billy Bob Thornton, Anthony Mackie, and Joaquin de Almeida. You'll know who he is. I'll talk about him in a minute. In 2002, Bolivian politician Pedro Castillo hires an American political consulting firm to help him win the 2002 Bolivian presidential election. The firm brings in Calamity Jane Bodine, played by Sandra Bullock, to manage Castillo's fledging campaign. The opposition's top political consultant is her nemesis, a fellow American played by Billy Bob Thornton, named Pat Candy. In Bolivia, the situation is tense as Bodine learns that the indigenous people, who are the majority of the country, lack any real political power and are protesting for a constitutional reform to get proper representation. The American consultants, not knowing the language or the culture of Bolivia, are persuaded by Bodine to follow a strategy of smear campaigning to make up for their candidates' shortcomings. However, Castillo refuses to give them permission to do so. It's only after Bodine arranges for the distribution of a flyer accusing Castillo of a long-ago affair and blaming it on the opposition does she finally get him to agree to smear his opponents. This was a semi-interesting movie for a couple of different reasons. But again, much like The Son of No One with Channing Tatum, it's another movie that has really good actors that do really good performances, but it's lacking a little bit extra to really put it over the edge. And I don't know, I'm not big on politics to begin with. I'm not big on political movies. And the fact that it's based off of actual events just goes to show that America seems to have the need and the want to be involved in every aspect of government in the world. There's no reason for any of us to be in the 2002 Bolivian presidential election, but it is kind of neat to see the contrast between Bullock's character and Joaquin de Almeida. Y'all know who he is. If you saw the guy, you're going to be like, hey, that's the bad guy. That's the bad guy from The Hitman's Bodyguard. That's the bad guy from Desperado. He's just the bad guy. He's always a bad guy in everything he plays. So it was kind of neat, though, to see the contrast between Bullock's character and his. He actually doesn't necessarily play a bad guy in this film. He's trying to be the president and do things the right way with a proper election, and not do the smear campaign, but as we said, after the fact, she gets him to agree. So it is another film that, again, excels in the acting department. The cast is very good. Billy Bob Thornton's really good in just about everything he does. Sandra Bullock was spot on. But again, it's lacking a little bit. Like, I think it wanted to be... Like, when it gets to the whole smear campaign part, I think it wanted to be a little bit more gritty or dirty than it actually came across to be. Because, I mean, let's face it, American politics is shit. There's not a lot of... and this goes back decades. This isn't anything new. But it's not so much about the principles. It's about, you know, what can we pin on the other guy? So... I don't want to get too involved with that. I don't really want to make this a political debate or any type, but the movie itself is not completely hateful. Another movie, 5 out of 10, you know, not great, not hateful, you know, it's worth a watch at least one time. So, and it is a 2015 film. I think I said 2016 earlier, but it is a 2015 film. So the last one I want to talk about, Daniel Radcliffe. Radcliffe plays the bad guy in The Lost City, and... He didn't get enough screen time, but that's okay. He wasn't supposed to, I guess. But I liked his character. I like seeing Daniel Radcliffe not be Harry Potter. I like seeing him break the mold and try to do new things and different things. Guy's got amazing range, as most British actors do, and can do a lot of really cool things. So the last one I want to talk about came out in 2019, and... I was really excited to finally sit down and be able to get to watch this. I've been wanting to see it for a long time. It's called Guns Akimbo. Guns Akimbo is a 2019 action comedy film written and directed by Jason Lee Howden. It stars Daniel Radcliffe, Samara Weaving, and Ned Dennehy. In an alternate near future, an underground fight club and criminal organization known as Schism has achieved massive popularity by live streaming real-life death matches between criminals and psychopaths. Ordinary computer programmer Miles Lee Harris, played by Daniel Radcliffe, gets his kicks by trolling online trolls and logs into Schism's forum one night to insult its viewers who turn murder into entertainment. Richtor, played by Ned Dennehy, is the criminal kingpin and psychopath who runs Schism, breaks into Miles' apartment with his henchmen, and after being beaten and drugged, Miles wakes up to find guns bolted to his hands. Miles learns that he has been forced to participate in a Schism match by being pitted against Nyx, the game's deadliest and craziest killer. She wants out, but Richtor requires her to kill Miles in order to get out altogether. Now this was a freaking fun movie. This was a good time. So this film actually came out 2019 at the Toronto Film Festival and then got released in March in New Zealand. But it didn't get an international release after that because of the pandemic. So I was never able to go to the theaters and see it. But I finally got to sit down and watch it. And it's an amazing, fun time. The movie isn't anything but ridiculous. And that's exactly what it tries to be. It doesn't try to be anything else. It's ridiculous. It's action-packed. There's shooting. There's killing. And that's all it is. If anybody's seen Shoot 'Em Up or Crank or Gunpowder Milkshake, it's that type of movie. It's ridiculous, it's fun, it's mindless. There's nothing behind it. There's no geopolitical agenda, there's no, you know, underlining message. It's just have a good time watching this, enjoy. And the film actually got its name, Guns Akimbo, from an old video game from like 1997 or something like that. It was a game called Blood. It was for PC. It was for the Microsoft DOS system. It was a first-person shooter, but one of the perks in the game was called Guns Akimbo, where you could wield two pistols. So since he's got two pistols bolted to his hands, they called it Guns Akimbo. So great movie. I would watch that one again for sure over the other two. I would watch Guns Akimbo all day long. That movie is hilarious. Daniel Radcliffe is amazing in that film. And the homeless guy, I don't know who the homeless guy is. I didn't even look him up. Actually, I did look him up. I didn't recognize his name. He does a lot of voiceover work. I forgot his name, but he's hilarious. The homeless guy in the movie is just amazing. I thought it was Ted Raimi, honestly, at first, with the way he was doing stuff with his eyes, but it looked like Ted Raimi, but it's not. But really, really fun movie, really good time. If you had to watch any of these three, watch that one. Just watch that one. It's ridiculous. It's stupid. I know, but it's more entertaining than the other two movies. So enjoy that one for sure. And then enjoy my video. Like, subscribe, comment to the channel. Please share the video. And let's keep trying to change the world one post at a time with some ridiculous stuff like guns akimbo. And I will see you guys soon in the next one.